This is Patrick Keenan, Biodiversity Research Institute's Outreach Director, and I'm here with a field report from this fall, 2010. BRI's Raptor Program Director, Chris DeSorbo, and his team set out to monitor migration on Monhegan Island in the Gulf of Maine. Monhegan Island has long been recognized by birdwatchers as a unique stopover site or migrant trap for birds on migration. Chris and his team set out to document how many raptors, that is, hawks and falcons, were flying past the island on their migration. In all, they counted over 800 hawks and falcons flying by the island, a large proportion of which were falcon species, such as American kestrels, peregrine falcons, and merlins. But Chris and his team had a second goal, to capture and band these migrating raptors, and if possible, place two satellite transmitters on two peregrine falcons. These satellite transmitters fit on the backs of the birds like a backpack. They're lightweight and they're complete with a solar panel. With this lightweight backpack, the bird is released to reveal its journey south. As this peregrine falcon is released, it flies out over the open water, over the Gulf of Maine, towards the south and east. The flight of the two falcons wearing satellite backpacks followed the Atlantic coast over the Gulf of Maine to Cape Hatteras in North Carolina, where each bird launched into a flight out over the open ocean, which then arced back towards the Caribbean and landed in Cuba. These birds continue their journey south today. Meanwhile, BRI biologists were working at other sites on islands and in coastal Maine to better understand the phenomenon of saw-whet owl migration. These small owls, about the size of robins or pigeons, migrate south each year from their expansive breeding grounds in the North Woods. However, their migration route is not well understood. Biologists use fine mesh nets and audio playbacks to attract migrating owls to the net area. BRI biologist Kate Williams led a coordinated netting effort along the coast of Maine from down east Maine near Lubeck to the southernmost site in Cape Elizabeth. In a considerable effort, BRI biologists captured and banded 253 saw-whet owls, including other species such as barred owls and a long-eared owl. Some of these owls were recaptures, that is, they had been banded at another site or in a previous year at another site. Capturing these birds sheds great insight about owl movements in coastal Maine.